This solar heater has been used by me for hot water supply of my summer cottage during last 5 years. But now I decided to dismantle this heater and replace it with this very simple and cheap solar hot water system, and I am sure my decision is right because of the following 6 reasons. This solar heater takes up much space, and here we can notice its hot water tank, which requires the space of my attic. Compared to that, my new solar heater does not require that additional tank or any other equipment. In addition, it is just my first experimental system, and some of my future systems will have such more compact shapes, and I will test them and describe them in my future videos. That is why my heater is connected to the house through these temporary hoses, not permanent reliable pipes. This is a very simple system, and it is easily made in a home workshop. My system has this black polymer sleeve, which is filled with water and covered with transparent sheets, and it is obvious that the sun will heat the water during the daytime. Now it is evening, and this sensor shows the temperature of the upper layer of the water, and we see that sometimes the sun can heat the water to a temperature of more than 70 degrees Celsius. This sensor measures the temperature of the lower water layer, which can be noticeably colder than the upper layer. It is obvious that the water will lose its heat during the night, and now we see the water temperature in the morning, when it can be almost 50 degrees Celsius. So, the water stores a stack of heat to transfer it to our clean water, which can move in this white pipe. The hot water of my old system had a pressure of about 2 meters, according to the level of hot water inside this tank in my attic. At the same time, the cold water has a standard pressure of 20 meters, and therefore I was forced to make such shower faucet. Unfortunately, this shower was uncomfortable. My wash basin mixer was traditional, but now we see that the flow of hot water was very bad, while the cold water had a normal flow. But this new system makes the pressure of hot water equal to the pressure of cold water, and therefore now I have the opportunity to comfortably use this traditional shower. In addition, now the wash basin mixer gives a normal flow of both hot and cold water. My old system required periodic additions of cold water to this tank in my attic, and now I open this tap to add the cold water. But I remind you that my new system has this white pipe, and the inlet of the pipe connects to the cold water supply of the house through this hose. At the same time, this hose goes from the pipe outlet here, and this place is intended for a similar electric heater, and these tubes must connect to these two pipes. Now I open the hot water tap, and we see the water which comes here, and before that it leaves the white pipe through this outlet. Let's take a look at the temperature of the water from the pipe outlet, when the sensor showed these temperatures of water inside that black sleeve. This sensor shows the degrees Celsius of the temperature of the water which leaves the white pipe. At first the temperature is almost 64 degrees, because it is the water which has been inside the pipe for a long time. However, the temperature decreases, because now we see water which also has long been inside the pipe, but near the bottom of that black sleeve, where the temperature is less. We must pay attention that the water temperature began to decrease rapidly, and that now more than 4 liters of water have left my solar heater. I use almost 40 meters of that white pipe with an inner diameter of 12 millimeters, and we can calculate that the internal volume of the pipe is 4 liters. But those 4 liters of very hot water have already left the white pipe, and now we see the water which came inside the pipe from the cold water system of my house about a minute ago. Now we see that the water temperature continues to decrease, but very slowly. That cold water had a temperature of 16 degrees Celsius, and we see the water which went through the white pipe, while the water quickly warmed from 16 to almost 50 degrees, because it took heat from the hot water inside the black sleeve. Of course, the temperature of the water from the white pipe gradually decreases because that water inside the black sleeve cools due to the fact that it transfers its own heat. So, we see that my solar heater has already produced 15 liters of hot water with a temperature between 64 and 44 degrees Celsius. This is the temperature of the water inside the black sleeve after the production of those 15 liters, and we see that the water became colder by about 8 degrees. The water inside similar tanks has a lot of dirt at the bottom of the tank, on the surface of the water and inside it. Happy are the people who don't see similar dirt inside these traditional hot water tanks because their desire to take a shower can decrease significantly. In addition, we know that a hot water tank can be an ideal place to live a variety of bacteria, including a very dangerous bacterium called Legionella. But all these problems are absent in my new system. The construction cost of the new system is several times cheaper than these traditional electric heaters and several dozen times cheaper than traditional solar hot water systems. The making of my system began with this box, which is thermal insulation with a thickness of 10 cm. We understand that this polystyrene box is just an experiment, and our box should be more beautiful, more durable, and protected from rainwater. Then I put these pieces of old black films. After that, I installed the black sleeve and the white pipe. At first, we fill the pipe with water, and then water is poured into the black sleeve. My sleeve is a black polyethylene film with a cost of 40 cents per square meter of a pair of the films, but its lifespan will be short. Therefore, I will have to replace the black sleeve every year. Also, we know about more durable black films, but they are more expensive. Of course, such air bubble should be removed because it reduces the efficiency of the solar heater, but similar air bubbles may appear again after a few weeks of the operation. Perhaps it will be better to put such additional black film on the north side of the heater because this zone is the weak point of the black sleeve due to the simultaneous action of the high temperatures and solar radiation. Making my system ends with the installation of a transparent cover, and I will describe various types of such covers in about a minute. It is important to note that my system is designed for the needs of one or two people. A large family will require a larger system with an area of several square meters and a width of 150 centimeters, which is equal to the standard width of similar polyethylene sleeves from a hardware store. I paid $20 for this 40 meters of polyethylene aluminum pipe with an outer diameter of 16 millimeters. However, I plan to do some experiments which may allow the use of a cheaper pipe with a length of 20 or 30 meters. Let's take a look at the work of different types of the transparent cover, which can be made of glass, cellular polycarbonate, several transparent sheets, and other variants. Now my solar heater is covered with a glass sheet, and this is the temperature of its water in the morning. This is the sky of that day, which was not perfectly sunny, and the sun heated the water to these temperatures in the evening. I remind you that this sensor shows the degree Celsius of the upper layer of the water inside the black sleeve, and this sensor measures the temperature of the lower layer. This is the water temperature the next morning, which became noticeably less due to heat leakages through the glass. Now I will show you the operation of the solar heater under a sheet of a cellular polycarbonate with a thickness of 4 mm. This is the situation in the morning, and then it was a sunny day, which heated the water to these temperatures in the evening. Now I am showing the temperature the next morning, and we see that it is 4 degrees Celsius more than it was in that case of the solar heater under a glass sheet. Then I put a glass sheet over that cellular polycarbonate, and this is the water temperature in the evening. The additional glass sheet significantly reduced the heat loss at night, and this is the temperature the next morning, and it is 7 degrees more than it was without the additional glass. Then the sunny day heated the water to the level of these temperatures in the evening. Let's look at the case if that sheet of cellular polycarbonate is covered with two glass sheets, and this is the temperature in the evening. It is obvious that now the water will keep its heat better, and this is the water temperature the next morning. If someone plans to take a shower in the morning, he can cover the solar heater with a blanket the night before. For example, if the water is heated to these temperatures in the evening, the water has these temperatures the next morning after 16 hours under a blanket. I must clarify that all these experiments were done when the height of the water inside this black sleeve was 9 centimeters. We can come to the conclusion that decreasing the height of the water increases its evening temperature but decreases its morning temperature. In addition, my experiments were done in the middle of Ukrainian August when the height of the sun above the horizon was approximately 55 degrees at noon. It is obvious that the solar heater will work better in most southern regions with higher sun. You might be interested to know how this white pipe copes with the heat transfer from the hot water of this black sleeve to clean water for a shower. I did my testing through this shower, which gave a water flow of 5.5 liters per minute. For example, these temperatures of my solar heater can give a comfortable shower, and I checked this fact. However, the comfortable shower took heat from my solar heater, and therefore its temperatures decreased to this level. This is another example of a situation when my solar heater can give a comfortable shower early in the morning. My check on this fact has taken the heat from the heater to the level of these temperatures. I want to clarify that my tests were done with this pipe, which is 4 spirals. The lower spiral lay on the bottom of the black sleeve and the upper spiral almost reached the upper film of the sleeve. It is obvious that the results of my test will be different if the spirals do not lay on the bottom but are located in the upper layer of water of the black sleeve. It is also obvious that the results will be different for solar heaters with a different area and a different height of water of the black sleeve. In addition, the cold water was coming here into the lower spiral and hot water was coming out through this pipe of the upper spiral. We understand that my results would be different if the inlet for the cold water will be here, at the beginning of the upper spiral. So, we could notice that sometimes the water inside the black sleeve does not have a temperature which is sufficient for a comfortable shower. That is why it may be better to connect the output of the solar heater to the input of your tank electric water heater. This connection ensures that you will always have hot water and the electricity consumption of your tank heater will decrease several times. However, it is possible that a more interesting variant is to connect the solar heater to the input of similar tankless electric heaters, but I did not test this idea experimentally. Unfortunately, this solar heater will not work well in Europe or Canada in the autumn months due to the low height of the sun above the horizon. That is why I plan to make another solar heater which will not have this disadvantage, and I will test it in the coming months.